In 1882, John B. Douglas and a group of citizens organized the Tyler Volunteer Fire Department, with Mr. Douglas serving as the first fire chief. At that time, their fire equipment consisted of canvas buckets with the name of the bucket's owner imprinted on the side. Over the next 26 years, as the city of Tyler continued to grow, so did the Volunteer Fire Department, adding new volunteers and acquiring new equipment. On January 1, 1908, the first paid Tyler Fire Department began operation under the supervision of Chief J.J. Daglish. This year, 2008, marks the 100th anniversary of the Tyler Fire Department as a fully paid fire department. Throughout this time, the Tyler Fire Department has witnessed numerous changes and has continued to grow and evolve into a highly professional organization. Former Battalion Chief William Crook started with the fire department in 1954 and worked 33 years with the department, retiring in 1987. He describes what it was like back when he started and what changes he saw during his time with the department.
I tell everybody, when I went to work on fire departments in the dark ages, we had no mask. And a year after I went to work, they started getting us those little canister masks. You got no gloves, you got no flashlight. And now, I think I got one new set of bunkers my whole career. If you had the budget when I went to work and the budget now, you'd probably think, golly, they've come a long way.
Fire Chief Neil Franklin agrees the department has come a long way over the past 100 years.
You know, years ago, back in 1908, they were horse-drawn. I mean, that's what we were looking at that time. Now we have pumper trucks that are like $500,000. It really, in a short period of time, it just radically changes. We've got thermal imaging cameras now that we can use in the smoke. Bodies will show up. We can find fire behind walls that we used to have to breach the wall, but now we can see hot spots behind the wall with these cameras. Automatic defibrillators. It's been the greatest thing that we've ever had. We've actually got GPS on our trucks. I was used to a yellow tablet and a pen. You know, it's just different now. Radio communication is better. Everything has improved in that way.
Chief Franklin says it's hard to imagine what it was like to fight fire back then with the tools and training they had.
I think about the individuals and how what their training level was compared to what our training level is now. The fire was just as hot back then as it is now. I mean, they had fire, we've got fire. But they were facing things kind of from the, it's all new. Well, we've got all these things, structured training and all this safety, you know, stuff that we put on that protects us.
One thing that has not changed over the last 100 years is the quality of the individuals that make up the Tyler Fire Department. It takes a special person to do this job. Caring, dedicated individuals with a passion for community service and the willingness to put their life on the line to help their fellow man in need. It's these qualities that set apart these individuals and help make the department what it is today.
We're here to help. That's what we're here for. That's our main job. All this other stuff aside, they could turn off the laptops and the mobile computers in the trucks. We're still going to respond, and we're going to get there, and we're going to take care of someone when they're in need.
Throughout the years, just like any other profession, the journey ends for some. They decide to retire and move on and begin a new chapter in their life. While each year a new class of probationary firefighters look to fill the shoes of those that came before them, probationary firefighter Steve Wietcher joined the department in August of 2007 after years of doing various jobs.
I don't know why the fire department didn't come to my mind sooner, because my first job out of college was computer systems engineering and analysis type of stuff, and I was behind a computer all day long, and I realized I hate being behind a computer. And then one day when I was at a job fair looking for jobs, I met Captain Aiken from the Tyler Fire Department. And he told me about how to apply and that I didn't need previous experience. And it just hit me like, wow, this would be a great job for me. You can do a lot of physical stuff, but you also use your mind. And there's a good brotherhood, a good sense of teamwork, as well as individual work. And everything about the fire department seemed to fit me pretty well.
It's that sense of brotherhood and the daily challenges that are faced that make individuals fall in love with this job.
The brotherhood aspect of the fire department is born out of the necessity to rely on each other. You basically spend a third of your life with these guys, and you're living with them, you're cooking with them. And then when you get in an emergency situation, you need to know them well and be able to trust your whole life with them.
That necessity to rely on each other is what forms such a strong bond, creating a tight-knit extended family. And as with any close-knit family, there's no shortage of good times and practical jokes.
One of the things you never do in a fire station is say, y'all can't do that to me, because that's just a dare that's gonna happen. There are just a multitude of stories of guys, you know, hanging somebody else's bunker clothes out on the flagpole. We had a guy's car that they set up a sprinkler when it was freezing cold outside and turned it into a popsicle. I mean, they had the sprinkler running all night long and it froze up the car solid.
Retired Administrative Secretary Margie Fields recalls when the guys even went so far as to sabotage her diet.
Other secretary and I went on a diet and we had skim milk in the refrigerator. They changed it out and put whole milk in there. They were terrible.
I think being a fireman is really kind of, once you're here and you get used to it, it gets to be a calling.
A calling that so many have answered, and one that will continue to be answered as future generations look to join the department.
We've got young people now, since 9/11, we've got young people that they had their heart set as a young age to be a firefighter.
For newbie Steve Wietcher, it's been a dream come true working for the Tyler Fire Department.
This is the best job I could ever imagine. Being a fireman for the city of Tyler is terrific. I couldn't have dreamed of a better job. And that makes me really proud. And I'm really happy to be a part of this organization.
For the veterans, they couldn't ever imagine doing any other job.
Once you get into it, and it's that family atmosphere, it's something that it gets in your system.
No, I wouldn't take anything from my time on the fire department. I doubt you'd find a fireman anywhere that would tell you that I wished I'd have been something else. I don't think you'd run across one.
You know, we joke around, we have fun at our job, we all enjoy it. There are guys, even the guys that may gripe sometimes about their job, you try to ask them to go do something else. They don't want to do it. They want to stay at the fire department.
For Chief Franklin, he couldn't be more proud of the department.
I'm proud of where this department's going, where we've come. We're a big city now, and we're meeting the challenges.
As for the future of the department,
my goal for the department is for us to be the most well-trained, most professional department in the state of Texas and possibly the United States. I really do feel that way. I want my guys to have so much confidence when they roll up on any situation that they're confident that they can take care of that problem, and they will.